各位弟兄姊妹，大家平安。
Thank God. Peace be to all the brothers and sisters.
过去两个星期啊，小弟被派到温哥华教会啊，在那边帮忙圣工。
I was sent to Vancouver Church to help out with the work there.
因为他们开了一个家庭教育的研习会。
And they had a seminar, a workshop on family education in a for religion.
两个题目啊，一个是以基督为中心的婚姻生活。
And the first topic was to have a marriage centered on Jesus Christ.
第二个题目是基督里的亲子教育。
And the second one was Jesus Christ and how to teach it.
感谢主，我看他们聚会的参加的情形非常热烈。
I saw that everyone was very enthusiastic there.
除了晚上聚会以外啊，安息日跟星期日是全天的研习会。
And there was some evening service, but there's also a full day of Saturday and Sunday.
他们的会堂啊，稍微比我们长一点，宽度大概一样，长度比我们长一点。
Their chapel is probably the same width as ours, and it's a little longer.
两个安息啊，两边啊，两边的教会大概坐满。
And the pews were all filled.
因为他们最近分了一个新的教会，那个会堂跟原来的会堂啊，那个格式一样啊，但是。里面的空间大概也差不多。
And they actually branched off into another church not too long ago, and the inside is about the same size as the original.
本来一个教会，结果两个教会都几乎坐满。
And thank God, both buildings are filled.
他们的慕道者相当多。
They have a lot of truth seekers.
那么星期四早上啊。有两个小时的慕道班。
Every Thursday morning, they have 2 hours of truth seeker class.
那个副堂啊，也几乎快坐满。
And even then, their room is filled.
我看到说啊，神在那边动工啊，真的。一方面，他们很热心传福音。
So Jesus is working hard there because on one part they're working very hard to preach the gospel.
一方面啊，大家很同心啊。所以神的同工啊，所以教会就兴旺起来。
And then secondly, everyone is working in unity and harmony.
我们也求主带领我们喜乐坡教会，大家能够更加同心，一起来兴旺福音。
And we hope that here in Hillsboro, we can also work together to spread the gospel.
尤其神给我们这么好的会堂，我们还有很多的空间啊。这个都是我们要努力的目标。
And so we still have a lot of room to grow here in Hillsboro, and that should be our goal.
今天早上我们来谈所罗门的华教。
This morning we're going to study the topic of Solomon's palanquin.
我们来看雅歌第三章。
Let's turn to Song of Solomon,
chapter 3. 雅歌第三章。
Song of Solomon, chapter 3.
第九节
，Verse 9，
所罗门王用黎巴嫩木为自己铸造一圣的华轿。第十节
，Ten，
浇筑是用银做的，浇底是用金做的，坐垫是紫色的，其中所铺的乃是耶路撒冷众女子的爱情。这个雅歌啊，我们说是谈到神跟人之间非常亲密的关系。
A Song of Solomon is a lesson in the relationship between God and human beings.
所以称为圣经里面的高峰篇啊，就是神跟人最亲密，好像夫妻一样的关系。
And then it exemplifies the relationship between God and people like that of husband and wife.
用很多的各样的方式来描写神怎么爱人。
And it uses many different ways to describe how God loves human beings.
这里啊，用这个所罗门王跟他所做的华轿，非常华美的一个轿， 来形容啊，就是有一种预表性，就教会跟基督之间的那个奥秘跟属灵的教训。
And the palanquin here is a symbol of how God establishes the church for human beings to be in there.
我们当然知道古时候的交通不方便啊，所以他们一开始是骑驴子啦，骑牛啦，或者骑马。
So back then we didn't have, they didn't have cars, so they would ride a horse or donkey or a mule.
或者有马车啊，来当作他们的交通工具。
Or they would ride a horse-drawn carriage.
但是有些尊贵的皇家里面啊，他们就用华美的装饰啊，这个做一个轿啊，来成为他们的交通工具。
And some wealthier families would actually have a palanquin.
这个轿是要有很多人来抬。
Palanquins, of course, are held by servants, human beings that carry them.
所以这个轿抬到哪里，那个坐轿的人就到哪里去。
And wherever the palanquin goes, the carriers of the palanquin go with it.
圣经里面说，所罗门王他是一个和平的君王。
Solomon was the king of peace.
预表耶稣基督啊，就是一个和平的君。
And he foreshadows Jesus as the King of Peace.
所以所罗门的教啊，就预表了荣耀的真教会。
And so Solomon's palanquin represents the glorious church.
因为这个荣耀的教会啊，要把耶稣基督的名声啊带到各地方去。
And the glorious church must carry the name of Jesus everywhere.
啊，来引导万民啊，来亲近神。来得到主的恩惠。
And this way, it brings everyone in the world to a knowledge of God's grace.
我们看哥林多后书第五章。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
哥林多后书第五章。
2 Corinthians chapter 5.
十八节。
Chapter 5, verse 18.
五章十八节。
2 Corinthians 5:18.
说一切都是出于神，他借着基督使我们与他和好。又将劝人与他和好的主分赐给我们19节
19.
这就是神在基督里面叫世人与自己和好，不将他们的罪过犯归在他们身上，并将这和好的道理托付了我们20节
20.
所以我们做基督的使者，就好像神借我们劝你们一般，我们替基督啊，求你们以神和好。所以耶稣基督啊，救赎我们。
So Jesus Christ came to save us.
把那个劝人和好的主恩就托付我们相信主救恩的人。
And he gave us his gospel salvation so that we can become his people.
所以我们得到主的恩惠，也是到处啊。来劝人跟基督和好。
And so we should do likewise and bring his gospel salvation so that people can be reconciled to Jesus.
所以这是真教会，也是真信徒同主领受的职分。
And this is the mission that the church and anyone who believes in the church
要借着和平的福音传到各地方为主做见证。然后主耶稣要再临。
All the members have this responsibility to preach the gospel of reconciliation until Jesus comes again.
我们刚刚读到这个第九节说，所罗门这个教是用一种特别的木头，叫做黎巴嫩木头来造的。
Coming back to Song of Solomon, chapter 3, verse 9, the palanquin was built of a special wood called the wood of Lebanon.
黎巴嫩啊，就在以色列地的北方。
Lebanon was a country to Israel's north.
它有一种黎巴嫩木，就是香柏木啊，特别出名。
And they had a special wood called the cedars of Lebanon.
这种香柏木啊，它的品质很坚硬。
It's a very hard wood.
非常挺直，它不会腐朽。
And it grows straight.
它也不会扭曲变形。
And it does not deform.
并且这个香柏木因为会发出 非常美的香气。
And not only that, but it has a pleasant smell.
所以在当时啊，是相当高贵的建筑材料。
And so this was a very valued construction material.
所罗门要建造圣殿的时候
，Solomon was to build the temple.
他就跟推雷王啊，跟他立约。
And he established a agreement with the king of
Lebanon. 说我现在要为神啊来建造圣殿。
Told the king of Lebanon, I'm going to build a temple for my God.
所以希望你呀啊给我啊一些香柏木。
And so please give me some cedars of Lebanon to build
a temple. 我把钱跟把一些粮食啊就送给你们。
And then I will send you some money and some of the produce of the land of Israel.
西兰王啊他就找了很多很多的工人啊啊在山上砍木头。
And so the king of Lebanon, his name is Hiram. And so Hiram ordered his men
to cut the cedars of Lebanon. 然后把它滚起来变成好像竹筏一样。啊、从这个上游的地方地中海边、啊啊、从那边、啊、就流下来
and then he would tie them together like a raft and send them downstream to Israel
流到以色列地的时候他们就把它捞起来然后把它运送到耶路撒冷
and once they reached Israel they would bring them onto the dry ground and send them over to Jerusalem、
啊、然后、啊、用这些木头、啊、来建造
And they used the cedars of Lebanon to build the temple for God.
那这里讲到说啊，这个所罗门同样用这个香柏木啊，啊为自己建造一个非常华美的教。
And so Solomon also used the cedars of Lebanon, the wood, to build himself a palanquin.
那这个香柏木啊，因为它有透湿的一些品质，所以就来象征。我们蒙主神造的真信徒应当有的品格。
And so the characteristics of the wood of Lebanon is emblematic of the characteristics we must have in building up the church.
因为香柏木是产自那个北方啊中年积雪的高山。
The cedars of Lebanon grow on the high mountains of the land.
它是在一个非常艰难的环境当中来成长。
And they grow in a harsh environment.
当我们信徒啊。还没有蒙主选召以前、啊、有的人心里很刚硬。
Some people, before they come to know Jesus, their heart is empty and filled with vanity.、
啊、当然也有人、啊、像那个拿但一样、啊、说他的心里是没有诡诈的。
But then there are also people who are of good heart, like the Nathaniel.、
啊、不管怎样，我们本来怎样的为人、啊当主耶稣的救恩临到我们以后、啊、他借着他的宝血来接近我们。
It doesn't matter what type of person we were before we came to know Jesus, but Jesus brings us to him and makes us a new person.
那我们成为他的子民、啊、他就是给我们各样属灵的恩赐。
So that we can become his people and we can be blessed in every way.
所以我们就借着各样的恩赐彼此互相的服侍啊、来建立基督的教会。
And with every grace that Jesus has imbued us with, we need to go and build up the church.、
啊、所以这个教会是借着主耶稣所选召的各样的门徒啊，啊来尽到个人的恩赐来建立起来的。
And so this church has been built upon every member's work in order to glorify God.、
啊、因为这个真教会啊。啊、有圣灵的同差、啊、所以圣灵会帮助我们信徒、啊、让我们的生命能够更新变化、
Because we have the Holy Spirit will help the true church to continue to grow
所以我们好像神的光、啊、神的荣光、啊、常常照耀我们、啊、所以我们就会反射出神的光来
And then God's light shines upon us and through us we bounce
所以信徒称为光明之子，还要把神的光啊照耀在这个黑暗的世界。
And so we must shine the light of God that has shone upon us to the rest of the world.
啊，这样借着这样啊，啊来荣耀神。
And this is how we bring glory to God in this world.
好像这个教也是一样啊，要让做教的人呐、啊，让这个所罗门王啊，让他得到荣耀一样。
And so the palanquin is the same way. Whoever sitting inside is someone who is being glorified.
这个刚刚我们读过的第十节啊，说这个胶的柱子啊是银的。
In verse 10, it says the pillars are made of silver.
啊，胶底啊是金的。
And its support of gold.
这个教啊，那个柱子，就是预表这个教会的至始。
And so this represents the foundations of the church.
啊，这个教会的柱子是用银来做的，银象征啊神的救赎的工作。
And the pillars are made of silver, and this is the saving grace and saving work of God.
因为我们有耶稣基督宝血的救赎嘛。
Because we have the blood of Jesus that washes away our sins.
我们才能够显出基督的形象来。
And this is how we can put on the image of Christ.
啊，才能够成为宝贵的活石头，啊，来建造神的殿。
So that we can become a living stone that's built into the temple of God.
圣经里面这个金金啊，一般都主着神的性情啊，神的尊荣。
And gold, of course, exemplifies the golden nature of God.
因为神是非常尊贵、非常荣耀的。
Because God is precious, God is filled with glory.
所以那个胶的底呀，是用金子打造出来的。
So the support is made of gold.
啊，这个底呀，就是根基。
And these are the foundations.
所以圣经里面说，这个教会的根基呀，是建立在使徒跟先知的基础上面。
And so the Bible tells us that the Church of God is built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets.
啊，有耶稣基督啊，亲自做这个啊教会的房角石。
And then Jesus Christ is the chief cornerstone.
哦，啊，所以这个教会啊，一定要建造在主耶稣宝贵的真理之上。
And so the church must be based upon the precious foundation of the truth of Jesus.
耶稣做房角石。
And Jesus is the cornerstone.
啊，所以这个教会才充满着丰盛的神的生命。
And then the church can be filled with the life of God.
还有神的性情在里面。
And the members can prosper inside.
所以保罗说啊，我们啊蒙拣选以后啊，神造就我们，就是让我们跟神的性情有份。
So Paul writes that we can be reconciled with Jesus, so we can have a part of Jesus.
啊，因为这个底呀，就是用金金来造的。
And that's because the support is made out of gold.
一方面，借着主耶稣的救赎。
Of course, there is the saving grace of Jesus.
啊，主耶稣的救恩在教会里面成为建设教会的啊柱石。
The word of salvation is the basis by which the church is established.
耶稣的救恩啊，他的生命，他的性情，成为教会的根基。
And Jesus is the foundation of the church.
第十节又说啊，这个胶里面有一个王要坐的座位。
And verse 10 tells us about the seat that the king sits on inside the palanquin.
啊，所以有一个座殿啊，啊，作为王的宝座。
And so there's this throne that he sits in inside of the palanquin.
啊，这个宝座啊是紫色的。
And the seat is of purple.
啊，当然我们知道古时候的帝王啊，他们的穿着都是紫色的，啊，象征非常尊贵的，非常啊高尚的。
We know that the kings of yesteryear wore purple to symbolize their royalty.
啊，说那个尼底亚是专门卖紫色布匹的，就是他的布啊，就是卖给那些尊贵的人，尊贵的。
And there was a saint named Lydia who was a seller of purple cloth, which was very valuable at that time.
啊，王的宝座啊，一方面是象征神的施恩。
And so the throne of a king symbolizes the
mercy of God. And
so it is filled with the grace of God.
希伯来书第四章说，我们尽管坦然来到神的施恩宝座前。
Hebrews chapter 4 tells us that we come before the throne of God, the mercy seat.
所以我们跪在神的面前祷告啊，我们不是对着空气，而是跪在神的宝座前。
And so today, when we come before God, we're not just kneeling before an empty seat, but rather through the
求神把他丰盛的恩典呢、啊，来赐给我们。
And then we ask God for His bounteous grace.
所以说，我们来到神面前的人都要相信有神，且相信神会把他丰盛的恩典赏赐给那些有信心向他祈求的人。
And so when we come before God, we have to have faith and pray to Him and ask Him for the mercy that He promises us.
所以我们今天来到真教会啊，就是来到神的施恩宝座前。
And so today, when we come before God, we come to the throne of grace before God.
启示录第四章啊，谈到说啊，有一个宝座设立了。
Revelation chapter 4 tells us about the throne in the kingdom of heaven.
啊，神坐在这个宝座上。
And God sits upon this throne.
啊，那个就预表说啊，末世神的救赎的经纶开始了。
And this tells us that in the last days, the salvation will be spread throughout the world.
啊，所以神借着圣灵来，印神的仆人的额头。
And because God wants to save the world, He sent His Son.
啊，每一个敬畏神的人，神都会在他的额上盖印。啊、所以神就认识谁是属他的人。
And then he puts a stamp upon those who belong to him, so that he will recognize those who belong to him.
啊、所以来到宝座前的人呐、啊，不管环境怎么变化，不管什么患难当中啊，啊他们都能够不断的歌颂神呐、啊，赞美神伟大的救恩、啊。
And so when we come to the throne of grace, we can all sing and shout praises and glory to the Heavenly Father.
因为神用帐幕护庇他们了、啊，让他们能够得到十分的平安。
Because God gives us a blessing, mercy, and grace and peace.
所以真教会就是神荣耀的宝座。
And so the true church is the throne of God.
我们看耶利米书十七章。
Let's turn to Jeremiah chapter 17.
十二节。
Jeremiah 17 verse 12.
耶利米书十七章十二节。
Jeremiah 17 verse 12.
说我们的圣所是荣耀的宝座，从太初啊安住在高处。好、哦，所以这个圣所就属神的教会，就是一个荣耀的宝座。
Verse 12 reads, "A glorious high throne from the beginning is the place of sanctuary. Then this is the church."
啊，所以的末世真教会出现了以后，神就坐在宝座上啊，要给那些啊。就近神面前的人、啊、给他们施行恩典。
And so in the true church, we can find the throne of God. And so if we come to the true church, God will give us grace.
所以我们无论什么事情、啊、都可以借着祷告、啊、向神说。
So it doesn't matter what our problem is, we can pray to God and God will listen.
神要赐给我们意外的平安，还要保守我们的心怀意念。
God will give us a peace beyond our understanding and guard our hearts in Him.
啊，但是这个宝座另外一方面呢、啊，就是意味着施行审判的。
But the throne also represents a place of judgment.
我们看希伯来书的十二章。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 12.
希伯来书的十二章。
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 22.
十二章二十二节。
Hebrews 12, verse 22.
你们乃是来到锡安山永生神的城，就是天上的耶路撒冷，那里有千万的天使。二三节。
23.
有名字记录在天上诸长子的会所共聚的总会，有审判众人的神，还有被成全之义人的灵魂。这里讲到这个锡安山啊，这属灵的锡安山，称为天上的耶路撒冷。
This passage talks about Mount Zion, which is also the heavenly Jerusalem.
说这个是一个永远不震动的国度，还要一直传到啊这个世界的末了。
And this is an eternal city, eternal kingdom that will last forever.
世界上的国度啊，最后都消失了，唯有这个神的国度啊，这个圣城新耶路撒冷。要存到最后，然后被主迎接回到天上去。
All the kingdoms of the earth will one day pass away.
啊，这个耶路撒冷有一个特色啊，就是有千千万万的天使。
But the heavenly kingdom will never pass away, and is filled with innumerable company of angels.
有耶稣做中保，还有耶稣的宝血的救赎。
And Jesus is the center of this kingdom. He is the protector and the judge and the
所以是所有被拣选的神的长子的聚会的所在。
And so this is where everyone who is saved comes together.
说这个真教会里面有神同在啊。他在审判，施行审判的权柄。
So in the true church, there is Jesus who casts judgment.
所以神的宝座有两个，一个是施恩，一个是审判。
And so the throne of God has both mercy and justice.
那些敬畏神的人啊，神就把各样平安、喜乐、各样的福分赐给他们。
And those who fear and worship God and with whom God is pleased, He blesses.
行恶的人啊，所以神就把患难困苦啊，跟永远的刑罚加在他们的身上。
On the other hand, if those who sin, God will punish eternally.
所以有一位坐宝座的，他的坐垫是紫色的，非常尊贵荣耀的。
So the king sits on his throne that is made of purple.
说所铺的都是耶路撒冷众女子的爱情。
Coming back to Song of Solomon, chapter 3, it says, the interior of the palanquin is paved with love.
耶路撒冷的众女子啊，就是指着那些敬畏神的那些圣徒。
And it's paved by the daughters of Jerusalem, which is the saints who believe in God.
所以这个所罗门的教的荣美啊，就是因为充满着圣徒的爱。
And the palanquin is glorious because it is filled with the love of the members who believe in God.
因为它是一个荣耀的宝座，所以众人喜欢羡慕这个神的教会。
And the palanquin is so glorious that everyone loves it.
所以这个真教会将来要建设达到完全充满神的荣耀，然后万民就要被吸引来流归这座山，一起来享受神家里面的荣耀。
And so the true church must be filled with members who want to glorify God and filled with love.
刚刚谈到说这个教它会发出非常芬香的香气。
And the palanquin has a wonderful aroma.
因为这个香柏木它经过各样的把它切割了把它磨光然后变成了一个非常华美的轿。
And in order to build a palanquin, one must cut the cedar tree down.
它原来那个香柏木的香气就会不断的发出香气来。
And as if you've ever smelled cedar wood, then you'll keep smelling that wonderful smell.
所以王坐在里面他就能够常常品尝那个香气。
And the king inside the palanquin can smell this wonderful smell.
还有在王身边在护卫王的那些勇士也一样来享受这个香气。
And those surrounding the Dali can also smell that wonderful smell.
所以圣经里面说因为我们蒙拣选了以后
Because the Bible tells us that after we're chosen by God,
我们会因为相信耶稣基督以后会发出一种馨香之气。
After we come to know Jesus, we will also have a wonderful aroma of Christ.
看哥林多后书第二章。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 2.
哥林多后书二章。
2 Corinthians chapter 2.
14节。
Verse
14. 感谢神常常率领我们在基督里面夸胜，并借着我们在各处显扬因为认识基督而有的香气，因为我们在神的面前，无论在得救的人身上，或在灭亡的人身上，都有基督馨香之气。16节
，16，
在这等人就做了死的香气，叫他死；在那等人就做了活的香气，叫他活。这是谁能够担当得起呢？这里讲到说因为我们领受了耶稣基督的救恩
This passage tells us that we have received the gospel salvation
from Jesus. 所以基督各样的荣耀、美德就临到我们的身上。
And so the glory of Christ has come upon us.
借着我们就显出因为基督而有的各样的香气。
And because of that, we have the wonderful fragrance of Christ.
这个香气能够带来非常大的力量。
And this fragrance of Christ empowers us.
说在那些虔诚的人，他们因为这个香气，所以被吸引来到主的面前，他们得到神的救恩，所以他们就得到福了，得到生命了。
And to those who receive the fragrance of Christ, who are saved, they can live life eternally.
但是对那些不相信的人，结果就变成他们的绊脚石，所以因为这个香气，因为他们不接受，后来他们就灭亡了，所以他们就对他们来讲就变成死的香气。
But to people who reject Jesus, who reject the gospel of salvation, then it brings death to them because it is their judgment.
所以因为我们所传的福音，还有我们的见证，变成能够 施行审判，当然不在我们，而是出于神的一种能力。
So the gospel of Christ, the gospel of salvation, can bring life and death.
神救赎我们，带给我们的香气。
And it is the gospel of Christ that gives us a wonderful fragrance.
受罪的一个主事。
But it can also condemn those who are sinners.
所以耶稣对门徒说，你们去传福音。
So Jesus commanded the disciples to go out and preach the gospel to all the nations.
信的人必然得救。
Those who believe will be saved.
对那些不信的人就要被定罪。
But those who reject the gospel will die.
所以表示说这个福音是相当有权柄的。
So this gospel is a gospel of power.
当然这个权柄是在乎神的灵。
And of course, this power comes from God.
所以耶稣说，耶稣对门徒说，我为你们吹一口气，叫你们得圣灵。
And so Jesus says, I will breathe on you and you will receive the Holy Spirit.
你们赦免的谁的罪，谁的罪就赦免了。
And whoever you forgive, their sins will be forgiven.
你们定了谁的罪，谁的罪就定了。
And whoever you condemn, their sins will be punished.
所以这个圣灵本身，它有留罪跟受罪的权柄。
So the Holy Spirit has the power to forgive and also the power to condemn.
同样的，神借着圣灵在我们身上，能够显出基督的香气来。
So Jesus gives us His Holy Spirit today so that we can have the aroma of Christ.
所以让我们活着说。 让耶稣基督在我们身上显彰，
so that we can exhibit the image of Christ, the behavior of Christ in our daily life.
让人看到说，就有耶稣基督活在我们身上。
So that people can see Jesus living in us.
因为我们成为世界上的光。
Because then we are the light of the world.
有的人被这个光吸引来到主面前的，他就能够活了。
Some people are attracted by the light of Christ. They'll come to the light and be saved.
所以说我们要把过去那个行为上的旧人把它脱掉。
So we must put aside our old selves.
就是以前不认识神的，存着西方的行为在行事。
Before we knew Christ, we may have lived in the way of the world, doing things very differently than we do now.
放纵私欲，贪行恶事。
Filled with hate, love, jealousy, greed.
不论言语上、行为上，都已经偏离了神的道。
And far away from the knowledge of God's way.
那我们今天领受了主的教训以后，我们生命就要更新变化。
But now that we come to a knowledge of the truth, then we need to change our lives.
旧人脱弃了，然后穿上新人。
Put aside the old person and put on a new person.
就是披戴耶稣基督。
Put on Jesus Christ.
所以我们是耶稣基督重新把我们改造的新人。
So we have been reborn again to become a new person.
在我们身上有真理，有仁爱。 又有圣洁的好品性。
And we'll have good behavior, we'll have the truth, and we'll have the light of God.
还有我们啊，靠着圣灵帮助，能够结出各样圣灵的美果。
And then we can bear the fruits of the Spirit.
还能够显扬基督的香气。
And then we'll have the pleasing fragrance of Christ.
另外说这个。教啊，是按照王的旨意来建造的。
And the palanquin is also built according to the will of the king.
因为所罗门王啊，按自己的旨意建造这个华教。
Because Solomon ordered that this palanquin be built.
为着要满足自己的喜悦。
In order to fulfill his own will.
啊，所以那个建造的工人啊，建造的人匠人啊。他完全是按照所罗门他的旨意，按照他的蓝图啊，来行事。
So the laborers and the craftsmen built this dali in accordance with how the king wanted it.
因为所罗门神给他非常大的智慧。
Now God gave Solomon
incredible wisdom. 所以他的心思意念算是完美的。
And so his thoughts, his plans were really good.
所以这个象征啊。我们在行事啊，不是按照我们人的主意，而是完全要按照神的心意来行事。
So when we're trying to build the church up, build our lives up around Christ, we must build it in accordance with the desires of Jesus.
我们看出埃及记二十五章。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 25.
出埃及记二十五章。
Exodus 25.
第八节。
Verse 8.
二十五章第八。
Exodus 25, verse 8.
说当为我造一个圣所，可以让我住在他们中间。第九节。
Nine.
制造帐幕和一切的器具啊，都要照我在山上所指示的样式。摩西到了山上四十昼夜啊，面对面见神。
Moses went up the mountain and he spoke with God face to face for 40 days and nights.
一方面把这个十条诫命用手指头写着，叫他带下来给百姓遵守。
God used his own hand to carve out the Ten Commandments in the tablets of stone, telling Moses, bring them down to
the people. 另外一个就是造一个会幕，啊，这个会幕啊，可以成为神跟人。可以相会的地方。
And also there should be a sanctuary where human beings could interact with God.
神特别说，你所有的样式材料要按照我在山上主示你的样式来建造。
And God commanded Moses, according to all that I show you, the pattern, the tabernacle, it's all furnishing, so shall you make it.
所以帐幕的大小材料，还有圣殿各样的器皿，神都一个一个非常详细的主示他。
And so God gave Moses very detailed instructions on how to build everything.
啊，所以摩西啊，要在山上神向他指示的样式来建造这个会幕。
And so Moses had to build the sanctuary in accordance with all those little details.
后来花了将近一年的时间把会幕造好了。
After a year, it was done.
啊，当会幕把它立起来的时候，说神的荣光啊，就充满着会幕。
And when the sanctuary was ready, then God's glory filled the sanctuary.
摩西进到住圣所的地方啊，神就在那个住圣所的地方啊，跟摩西讲话。
And then Moses went into the most holy, and there God spoke to Moses.
啊，把一些啊教训就传给他。啊，他在传达给以色列人。
And gave Moses more instructions that he was to pass on to the Israelites.
啊，所以因为这个会幕是按照神的主事啊来建造起来的。
And because the tabernacle sanctuary were built in accordance with instructions.
所以有神跟他们同在，跟他们来往。
And then God was willing to dwell among His people.
神在那里跟他们施恩啊，啊来带领他们。
God was willing to give them grace and mercy and lead them personally.
所罗门建造圣殿的时候，
Solomon built the temple.
大卫也是一直在吩咐他。
David commanded his son Solomon.
啊，说你要什么样的材料，要怎么建造？
You should build the temple in such and such a fashion, using.
然后对他说啊。啊，这个都是神亲自指示我，而且用指头画给我看的。
Because these were detailed instructions that God had given me to how his temple should be built.
所以大卫甲把他从神领受的怎么来建造圣殿。
And so David passed on the instructions that God had given him on how to
build the temple. 一一的交代所罗门。
And painstakingly passed on these instructions.
后来所罗门就把这个圣殿盖起来了。
And so Solomon did indeed build the temple.
所以最后把那个约柜啊搬到住圣所的时候。
And finally brought the Ark of Covenant into the Most Holy.
说那个时候，神的荣光啊，就充满这个圣殿。
It was at that time the glory of God filled the temple.
好，啊，所以他们就在那边献上祷告啊，啊，把这个圣殿献给神。
So they consecrated the temple, offering sacrifices to God.
啊，常常在圣殿里面守节。
They would observe their festivals.
啊，所以不管从造这个方舟也好，造会幕、造圣殿都是一样。
So regardless what you're building, the tabernacle, the Ark of the Covenant, the sanctuary,
所有的都是神一一的主事来建造的。
All of this must be built in accordance with the detailed instructions of God.
所以今天呢，真教会的建设也是一样。
Same with the true church today.
因为神为着自己啊。来建造他的教会。
Because God wants His church to be built in accordance with His instructions.
所以我们刚刚谈到说，要以使徒先知啊做根基。
And so the church is built on the foundations of the apostles and the
saints. 耶稣基督做王角石。
Jesus is the cornerstone.
啊，所以我们要按照神所吩咐的，把这个道理传得全备。
And then in accordance with Jesus' commandments, we have to preach the gospel to the ends of the world.
啊，才能够把人完完全全的带到神面前。
And this way, all humankind can be saved and brought before God.
啊，这个教会啊，道理传得全备，才能够带领信徒啊，追求圣洁完全呐。
And then all human beings can pursue holiness and righteousness.
啊，所以以弗所书第五章二十六节说，要用水借着道把教会洗得干净。
And so Ephesians 5 verse 25 says that we must use water to wash away the dirt in the church.
啊，成为一个圣洁荣耀的教会，来献给他自己呀。所以，主耶稣把这个教会建设圣洁完全，来献给他自己，做一个荣耀的教会。
Jesus Christ loves the church, and He sanctifies and cleanses her with washing of water by the Word to present herself as holy and righteous to Himself as a
我们再看回来这个雅歌三章。
Let's turn back to Song of Solomon chapter 3.
我们看第七节。
Song of Solomon chapter 3 verse 7.
雅歌三章第七节。
Song of Solomon chapter 3 verse 7.
看啊，是所罗门的轿，四围有六十个勇士，都是以色列中的勇士。第八节。
Verse 8.
所得持刀善于征战，腰间佩刀，防备夜间有惊慌啊。这里讲到说，这个所罗门的轿来了，所以他们说：“你们看啊，所罗门的轿来了。”
Verse 7 says, "It is Solomon's couch," and so everyone shouts, "It is Solomon's couch. He is coming."
啊，这个所罗门的轿旁边呢、啊，有六十个勇士。
Around Solomon's couch, there are 60 valiant warriors.
啊，这个六十个勇士当中啊，有的是抬轿的，有的是做护卫的。
And some of these valiant men are carrying the palanquin.
所以他们都是以色列当中啊最重要的勇士。
And these are the heroes, the brave men of the Israel.
啊，他们都是啊，经过、啊。精炼的非常威武的神国的勇士。
And these are the warriors who have been trained to fight war.
啊，来抬王的轿，还有护卫王的。
So that they can carry the palanquin of the king and also surround and protect the king.
啊，所以真信徒啊，要成为基督的精兵啊，勇士。
And so the saints today in church, Christians, must be warriors for God.
还要来护卫真理呀、啊，啊，为主征战。
To fight a spiritual battle for the King, Jesus.
说啊，耶稣基督就是我们的元帅。
Jesus is our leader.
所以我们都是他带领之下的精兵勇士。
He is our general, and we are his soldiers.
所以我们要跟属灵的恶魔啊来征战。
And so we have to fight against the spiritual forces of darkness.
所以我们要靠主胜过这个黑暗的权势。
Relying on the power of Jesus, we must overcome the evil in the world.
所以每个勇士都要善于征战，手都要拿刀。
And so every valiant warrior must have his sword.
这个刀啊，就是神的刀。
And the sword is the word of God.
所以希伯来书第四章十二节里面说，神的道好像那个一把双刃的利剑。
And so, Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 likens the word of God to a weapon of war.
是我们属灵征战的武器。
It is a spiritual warfare, and that's our instrument of war.
所以我们一定要固守真理的奥秘。
And so we have to grasp on to the deep mysteries of Christ and the
gospel. 来胜过仇敌的一切挑衅。
And then we can overcome all the dastardly conspiracies from our enemy.
好，所以神的道非常重要哦。
The word of God is very important.
这是我们属灵征战要得胜的非常重要的工具。
And this is how we gain the victory is through the word of God.
我们看到亚当夏娃会失败，就是因为他们没有坚守神的道。
Adam and Eve failed because they did not uphold the word of God.
神明明说啊，这个善恶树上的果子你不可以吃，吃了一定死。
But God said very plainly, "Do not eat of this fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil."
结果魔鬼就迷惑他说啊。神怕你太聪明了，所以叫你不要吃这个善恶果啊。
And Satan said, "Well, God doesn't want you to be too wise, and so he told you don't eat of this fruit."
夏娃说啊，啊，神说啊，免得你们死了。
And Eve said, will we certainly die?"
所以他对神的话就改变了，所以给魔鬼有一个攻击的机会。
Eve was confused and said, "We should not touch it." And so this opened the door for Satan to deceive her.
魔鬼就跟他讲说，不会的，你不会死啦。
And then Satan said, "No, you're not going to die."
你出来以后还会像神一样的聪明有智慧。
In fact, you'll be just as smart as God.
结果他越看越好吃啊，就摘下来就吃了啊，然后又拿给亚当吃。
And Eve took the fruit and ate it, and then she gave it to her husband Adam.
所以因为违背神的话，罪就进到世界，人类就在劳苦死亡当中。
And because they disobeyed the word of God, sin came into the world, and human beings were cursed.
所以神的话是很坚定的，不容易改变的。
So the word of God does not change; it is eternal.
所以神的道安定在天呐，直到永远。
And so the word of God persists forever in heaven and earth.
魔鬼攻击人的方式就是改变神的话。
And Satan wants to trick us by changing the word of God.
所以后来要试探耶稣的时候，
And so Satan came to tempt Jesus.
就对他说啊，你如果是神的儿子，你可以把石头变成饼来吃啊。
Satan said to Jesus, "Well, if you're truly the Son of God, you can change this stone into bread so you can eat it."
Yes, 对耶稣来讲，要变个食物啊，对他来讲没有什么困难。
This was not a difficult miracle for Jesus.
但是他不会满足自己的私欲来行神迹。
But Jesus did not wish to perform a miracle just to satisfy his
own desires. 他在行神迹啊，都是要荣耀神，要让人得益处。
But instead, he wished to perform miracles to glorify the name of God and to
bring benefit to other people. 他也知道说，人活着不是看着光靠食物。
And he realized that human beings did not live to eat bread
alone. 是要靠着神口里所出的话。
A man should not live by bread alone, but by the word of God.
神让人活啊，人就活下去。
And so, if God wants human beings to live, you'll live.
神如果不让人活啊，你再多的食物啊，人都没有办法活下去。
If God doesn't want you to live, then it doesn't matter what you do, you're going to die.
所以人能够活着，就是因为神的话。
So today we live by the word of God.
所以魔鬼虽然一直的试探啊主耶稣，但是主耶稣都用神的话一一的来战胜了撒旦。
And so Satan wished to tempt Jesus by distorting the words of God, but Jesus used the word of God to overcome him.
所以说我们今天要做一个刚强的人。
And so today, if we want to be a strong,
穿戴神赐给我们的全副军装。
If we want to put on the full,
一方面有信心、德性，当作盾牌，所以让魔鬼没有办法攻进来。
We have to put on the full armor so that we do not leave any way for Satan to
attack us. 另外，我们要拿着圣灵的宝剑，就是神的道。就能够战胜魔鬼。
We have to hold the Holy Spirit's weapon of, which is the sword of the Spirit and the Word of God.
所以说这些精兵勇士啊，他们一定要拿着刀来得胜。
That's why in Song of Solomon chapter 3 verse 7 it says the valiant men hold swords.
另外一说啊，这个腰间也要配刀。
And here in verse 8 it says they have a sword on their thigh.
腰就是我们人发挥力量的地方。
From our thighs we get strength.
所以圣经里面说，我们要用真理跟圣灵的能力来束腰。
And so the Holy Spirit and the sword of the Spirit, the Word of God, we must gird ourselves with that.
所以我们就能够胜过那个黑夜的惊慌。
So that we can overcome the darkness.
所以现在就是黑暗的时候啊，就是啊。魔鬼啊，在世界上啊，造成混乱的时代。
So there is night in the world, and that is Satan bringing about his darkness.
所以说啊，因为魔鬼知道自己的时候不多啊，所以他就用尽各样的方法来迷惑世人。
So the Bible says Satan knows that his time is short, and therefore he tries to use every way to corrupt the souls of mankind.
用各样的异端呐、啊。不走世上的风俗啊，来迷惑世人，来离开神。
To use heresy, blasphemies, false teachings, all sorts of temptations to lead human beings away from God.
所以在夜间呐、啊，就是撒旦呐、啊、攻击世人的机会。
So during this night, the world, that's when Satan will attack.
所以我们应当更加的警醒啊。
And so we have to be alert and vigilant.
要腰间配刀啊。
We have to gird ourselves with the sword of the Spirit.
我们就能够防备夜间的惊慌。
And then we can overcome the fear of the night.
所以我们要成为真理勇士，要穿戴这个全副的军装啊，来得胜。
And so we have to put on the Word of God as our armor.
我们最后看这个雅歌三章十一节。
Let's turn to Song of Solomon 3 verse 11.
雅歌三章十一节。
Song of Solomon 3 verse 11。
西安的众女子啊，你们出去观看所罗门王头戴冠冕，就是在他婚宴的日子，心中喜乐的时候，他母亲给他戴上的。这里讲到说，西安的女子，你们来看啊，这个所罗门要婚娶的时候到了。
And so, verse 11, there's an invitation. Go forth, O daughters of Zion, come to King Solomon's wedding.
这个所罗门王啊，戴上一个啊，非常啊漂亮的王冠。
Because the King Solomon's wearing a glorious crown.
说这个王冠是母亲给他戴上的。
This crown was bestowed upon him by his mother.
刚刚我们谈过说，西安的众女子啊。或者是耶路撒冷的众女子，都是主着灵性长进的属灵信徒。
And the daughters of Jerusalem, the daughters of Zion, are the saints in the church.
说因为羔羊婚娶的时候到了，他们同样被邀请来参加羔羊的婚姻的喜宴。
And so they are invited to the sacred lamb's wedding.
所以真信徒啊。一方面是成为羔羊的妻子，被主啊迎娶，因为他装束整齐了。
So the daughters of Zion, the daughters of Jerusalem, the saints are invited to this marriage festival.
一方面也是被迎娶，被请来参加羔羊婚宴的这些宾客啊。
They're also the guests, but they're also the ones who are being married.
所以有机会啊，被邀来参加这个羔羊的婚宴的人是有福的。
And so it is a blessing to be invited to this wedding feast.
因为他们同时也是羔羊的新妇，因为装束整齐了。
They are the bride of the groom, but they're also the guests of the groom.
他说这个婚宴的时候到了。
So it is time for the wedding.
也就是啊。真教会啊，享受灵恩丰盛啊，就是装束整齐。
And that's when the true church will receive a great day of joy and happiness.
啊，就是要等候啊，丈夫迎娶的荣美的新妇的时候。
For that wonderful day of the wedding.
他说这个所罗门王他能够戴上一个非常荣耀的冠冕。
So King Solomon wore this great crown.
啊，这个荣耀是从哪里来？说母亲给他戴上的。
And this crown came from his mother.
啊，这个母亲啊，在圣经里面指的就是真教会啊。
And the mother
是信徒的母。
The mother in the church is the true church.
因为这个教会啊，建设到完全啊，啊，成为一个荣美的教会。
And the true church will be a glorious church.
啊，所以让基督啊，他就大大得到荣耀。
And Jesus will be glorified through the church.
啊，所以我们真信徒啊，如果真正按照神的旨意来行事。
The saints in the church, if we follow the words of
the
Bible,
人人在各样的美德上啊，都达到成圣完全。
And then we can fear God, keep His commandments, and be glorious.
啊，这个教会啊，得到复兴啊，在世上大大的发光。
And then the church will be glorious and shed the glorious light of Jesus.
所以耶稣基督啊，就因为教会啊，得到他应得的荣耀。
And then Jesus will get the glory that He deserves.
啊，这是我们所有真信徒啊，每一个人呐、啊，都要自觉的本分。也是我们应当努力的目标。
And this is the goals that all the members should seek after.
我们来唱诗223首。
Let's sing hymn 223.